Hello, everybody. I come with a bullet this time. Yeah, I bite. Nice and clean. Doing laundry. And it's laundry day. It's all nasty and rainy. Because I was going to do a video. I was going to fire this. Yeah. However, this one is a training rifle, though. You've seen it in another video. But I was going to do a firing demonstration. Out there, of course, I was going to shoot out there on the balcony. Just one fire, or one shot, but it's nasty and rainy, and yeah, I don't like these old guns getting wet. I want to keep them in good condition as long as possible. And I was going to fire this one too. Looks like the same gun. This one's the 99 variant. Long rifle, but still 6.5 because it's a trainer. It's not going to pick up, but it does have an anchor mub at the top there. This is a Navy trainer. Trainers and Navy specials all have proof marks down here on the underneath the tang, where my thumb is. Right there, that little part that it ain't picking up too well. That's a Navy stamp. Yeah, it looks like a 38, but it's not. We were gonna shoot both of these. Oh, and my, I got a bolt replacement for that other one. Not that I needed it, but it's nice to have parts just in case. Give me a second. This is, I know, kind of a random video. This right here. As a training bolt, so the one for the other, the Type 38 version. It's all number matching. And as if you're wanting to know what this is for gas pressure, just for a safety feature, even though it's a blank that it fires. Well, the bolt works, everything, you know, when I put the bolt into the other rifle, it fires, it works. However, if you part all this out, take the safety numb off, or if you take the firing pin out and all that and try to switch the parts with the other, it will not work. And that's what I wanted to point out with people. When you buy parts, especially for the training version, you have to know what you have. And even when you do buy something like this, you're taking a major risk of it not going to work. But however, the whole bolt itself will work, but all the parts are not interchangeable with the other bolt, so I can't put the other firing pin in this one, or switch this firing pin and put it in the other one, because the cutouts, even though it's the same bolt, same lengths, measurements, and weight, the cutouts are completely different. Like here, how it's got the horizontal nub on it. Well, the other safety tang, it's sideways, it's crisscross instead of up and down. So you can't put the other safety knob, and the cutouts in the firing pin are different too. I mean, that's a big, and see, it's also designed too for gas pressure, even though it's only shooting blanks. I saw another bid, another auction. It was on a eBay for another trainer bolt, but it was the one that had the locking lugs. It looks identical to a Type 38. I tried to get that, but of course some loser waited until it had like 3 minutes left and made a huge bid on it so he could win. I hate people that do that. I always bid when it has 2 or 3 days on it. When I do, I don't bid at the last minute because I consider that cheating. Anyways, let's continue. And here is the Type 99 with a reproduction sling. It makes my whole place smell like leather. It smells actually pretty good for the, and it's real leather. And if you're wanting to know, well, what's that plastic thing right there on the end of that cap? That's called a muzzle cap. In World War II, Japanese had them. They were either made out of some kind of plastic like this one here. This is a repo, though. Or they were made out of brass or copper. And all it is to keep dirt and grud going down into your bore. Everything else besides that in the sling, everything is authentic. It's got the beautiful anti-aircraft sights. It does have the mum, but it's been molested. But there's proof that, you know, it's there. It's just been scrubbed out. Other than that, everything's number matching on this gun. And honestly, it's, the weight is not bad. This is a very comfortable rifle. Kicks like a damn mule. And yeah, also got some blanks there loaded into it too. 7.7 blanks. Because that's what you typically shoot to save the ammo that you have, while everybody else is panic buying ammunition. They're thinking, oh no, Joe Biden's going to take my guns away. Oh no, there was a mass shooting. They're going to take my guns away. Good luck. It's not going to happen. So if any of y'all are watching this, don't be freaked out. Your guns ain't going anywhere, guys. They're going to be right there to the rightful owner, which is you and me. We're not going to have no guns taken away from here. Yeah. But despite this one being a trainer, this is nice. Oh, I see my PUD there. I don't like that. This is heavy though too. This is a lot heavier than the Type 99. It's a lot longer rifle too though. It's got some good weight. Unfortunately though, I wanted to talk about, everyone says cast iron receivers. This one, however, is not cast iron. It's steel, but it's not heat treated. Because this was never designed to be a combat rifle. This was to train soldiers, even school children and stuff. But this is not a school rifle. This is a military trainer. Some of these you can find that's got a conversion kit where they switched out the barrel and had to put a rifle barrel in there. But most of the time those are rare, so the only ones you find is the basic, which is the smoothbore. Alrighty. Well, that's going to be the end of this video. I meant to say, no more brown. I've had it cut and I bleached it. I like it. It's a new look for me. It's a mess right now though, but because it's dry, it needs to be treated some more. Anyways, the whole point of the video, I was going to go out and go boom, but I ain't going to do it with the rain. Just don't want no rust or anything to put these to make them. I want these to last a lot longer. I baby them, if you haven't noticed. I treat them like if they're basically toddlers. But yeah, I was going to prove a point that you can actually shoot training rifle with blank ammunition and it's not going to blow up, even though people are, I'm scared of it. It'll blow up in your face. No, don't do it. Don't do it. I've had all kinds of people tell me, oh, don't do it. Well, yeah, maybe if you're ignorant and you don't know what you're doing, yeah, don't do it. But I do know. I have done years of research trying to find out every little thing about training rifles and the mislead information that people say. And that said, I have shot this one several times. There's also 6.5 blank ammunition in there. Watch this. There's one in the chamber. See how it kicked it out? Kicks it just like if it was a combat. There's another one in the chamber. See? And my hair again, always getting in the damn way. I'll push down. But if you wanted to, you could load a full mag in with stripper clips, put a 5-round in, and then put another one up above, click it, and then close the bolt and you'll have 6. Some people ain't aware of that. But no, if I knew the correct training ammunition, because they didn't typically just shoot plain blanks like this. They either had the, gosh damn hair, they either had the wooden bullet, or they had the one that was had a little steel cap on the end for basically planking training, and then they had one that was a 6.5 diameter ball, like a BB, you know, like a BB gun, but 6.5 caliber, that fed it on the end of the cartilage, and those shot. And actually, if you got hit by one of those, it'd probably kill you in the chest or whatever they were. And that was also a training round, but nobody knows the correct powder charge, because I'd like to reload actual, historically, the correct training ammunition, and then actually shoot this and see how the accuracy is on, even though it's a smoothbore. Because it's one thing I wanted to point out, too, is, you know, they got sights, adjustable. This one goes out, which is ridiculously, 2,400 meters. So they did train, they had stuff to shoot for ranges and all that. So the whole story that these were just wall hangers, no. I put a lot of money and time and research in this kind of stuff. Just to point that out. That's why I do more training rifle videos than I do combat, because there's plenty of them. We already know pretty much everything there is about them. But everybody are scared to death of these, thinking they're going to grenade in your face, and it's not going to happen, guys. Training rifles are just as nice. They also have the same type of historic value as your combat rifles. Some of these, actually, I've seen some go for like 800, like if the Navy one, if it's all there, cleaning rod, matching numbers, in really good condition, I've seen them sell for 800. I wouldn't pay that, though. That's a little high. And what else was I going to say? Oh, and then the child version was like this, except it was an eighth of a scale. It probably came down to about right here where my finger is, where the barrel was, or where, you know, that's. And those also shot blanks. Well, training ammunition, but you could put a blank in it and fire it as long as everything works. Good luck finding parts. Parts for this kind of stuff is really hard. And you don't know if it's going to work or not, because they were all fitted differently. So each and every rifle you have of one of these, say you have 3 of the piece type training rifles like this, all 3 of them are going to be unique, one of a kind. They're not exactly the same. The parts are all cut out different and fitted different. Or speaking of that, I think somebody here was like, I don't believe you, you're lying, you're full of shit. So okay, I'm going to prove that. I already told you this bolt will work in it. See, there's the bolt. There it is. And it will fire. Make sure I don't have nothing in the chamber here. Do the little finger hole thing. And now, bang. See. See? It works. I already did a blank fire with this bolt too. Now on this one, since it's a little, it ain't matching number to this rifle, right here, it sticks a little bit. So you just gotta be a little rough. And it comes right out. See, this is all matching, just not to the gun. However, this one is. And you will find some trainers with different bolt parts that ain't matching. And I'm going to be honest with you, if it doesn't work, it's basically junk. And if you're like me, that like these and like to put them back in actually working condition, where you can actually use it, that can be quite a bit of challenge. Just depends. Lining up the bolt and the dust cover is such a bitch on these. Easier on the combat rifle. Oh my god. Have a little patience, I'm working on it. There we go. Now it's on there. Rattly thing. There it is. Now, when you find trainers, most of them you're not going to find dust covers. And if you're trying to find a dust cover for a trainer, good luck, because there was training dust covers were all fitted differently too, so it's a needle in a haystack with those. So I wouldn't even bother buying one unless it's there on the gun when you're wanting to buy one of these. And it's funny, because even though depending on what type of trainers rifles that you buy, some of them do not require FFL to own, but however, like one like this one does. But it's a nice piece of history. Too bad I can't shoot it to show you, to prove to you that it won't blow up, but it's loud. I was going to get my earpiece. So this thing is just as loud as your basic Type 38. I mean, it boom. Just, I want to fire it so bad. But I can't. I don't want this to get wet and raindrops on it. I mean, yeah, I got stuff to clean, and I just don't. Like I said, I baby them. Y'all have a nice day. This wasn't the typical video I was planning on doing, and plus I lollygagged way too much. I need to wrap this up. So y'all have a good day, and be safe out there, and stay strong about and support guns, and anyone who anti-people that don't like the guns and want to take gun rights or restrict rights, tell them to go fuck themselves, because we're in this together, and we're going to stay strong, and we're going to enjoy our firearms. Have a good day. Well, unfortunately, when I recorded and when I fired the shot, I went back to listen to the sound. Well, this camera, the quality, audio quality wasn't that great. It just had that little pop, you know, thud. If you've seen other videos when someone's shooting, you hear that weird poop noise. That's because the audio or camera quality can't pick up that kind of sound quality. So I'm sorry, I bumped it so it's not going to be added into the video, but I will say you can perfectly shoot safely with blank ammunition a training rifle. But yes, this one right here, I had the picture, I added it to the video where I took it out to shoot. It didn't blow up, it's still here. And I'm still in one piece, so now people can relax, educate yourself a little more on this subject, it ain't gonna blow up unless you got one that's been damaged. So have a good day, and again, I'm sorry that this camera is not meant for, you know, for firearms to pick up real loud sounds. So maybe in the future I'll get a better camera and we can do a better video where you can actually hear the true sound of one of these, because it's loud. Very loud indeed. Even though with the blank, just as loud as your normal 6.5 ammunition. They're full load blanks anyways. Perfect and safe to shoot in one of these. But remember, never attempt to put a live round in one of these, because it was not designed for that. Y'all have a good day.